So I would like to speak about two topics of our conference together. So first of all, I would like to speak about the main and general conditions of the land transaction in Hungary. In this part, I would like to speak about the acquisition by legal persons, and of course, the other topics, so about the succession, about the land succession. So, according to the accession treaty, Hungary may maintain force for 7 years from the date of accession, the prohibitions laid down in its legislation existing at the time of the signature of this act on the acquisition of agricultural land by natural persons who are non-residents or non-citizens of Hungary and by legal persons. So the Europe Committee agreed maintenance of the land moratorium till the 30th April 2014, which end is necessary to legislate a new act on land transaction in Hungary. Thus, the Land Transaction Act was adopted, which entered into force on 1st May 2014. So the Land Transaction Act was the first cardinal act in this sector, which was adopted among the others prescribed by the fundamental law. And the partly cardinal act, the so-called land, was also adopted, which is on certain provisions and transition related to the Land Transaction Act, and additionally to other cardinal acts will be adopted, namely the Act on Agricultural Holdings and on Integrated Agricultural Production. So, the Land Transaction Act governs the acquisition of ownership and usufruct rights on agricultural and forestry land, the use of land, as well as the monitoring of restrictions on land acquisitions, and contains provisions on local land commissions. The scope of this act covers the acquisition of ownership of land under any title and by any means, but not including where ownership is acquired by way of the state succession, offer to the state in probate proceedings, expropriation, or through auction for the purpose of indemnification. So the scope of the Land Transaction Act doesn't cover the acquisition of ownership of land by way of interstate succession. We have to use the general rules of the law of succession based on the civil code. However, the Act, so the Land Transaction Act, contains special rules of acquisition of ownership of land by testamentary disposition. The Act applies to all lands located in the territory of Hungary. However, the rules on agricultural holdings will be governed in a specific Act, yet only conceptual definitions relating agricultural holding can be found in the Land Transaction Act. In principle, the ownership of land may be acquired by domestic natural persons and EU nationals. The Land Transaction Act introduced the concept of farmer, and only those people can take part at the domestic land markets who meet these criteria. In the case of land acquisition limit, the size of land that can be acquired by a farmer and a close relative of the person transferring ownership right of the land is not a farmer, so it may not exceed 300 hectares. Other than farmers, so Hungarian natural persons and EU nationals may acquire the ownership of land if size of the land does not exceed 1 hectare. Currently, the ownership of agricultural land can only be acquired by certain legal persons, and they can only acquire it with special conditions. Among the legal persons, ownership of land can be acquired without any restrictions by the state, and the conditions by a listed church or the internal legal entities thereof. And a mortgage loan company and by a municipal government of the community where the land is located. So these are the persons who can, with conditions, acquire the land. A further favorable rule for these legal persons is that the rule of land acquisition limit shall not be applied to them. In addition, other legal persons may not acquire ownership of the land, and certain three natural persons and foreign states. In the case of land transaction between living persons, the approval of the competent authority is a special regulatory instrument. Transactions in the case of land acquisition can be classified into three groups in respect of approval of the competent authority. The first group includes the case of acquisition of ownership of land by sales contract. Acquisition of ownership of land under other title creates the second group. And the third group consists the land of land acquisition for which the approval of the competent authority not required. In the case of the approval of the sales contract by the competent authority, the sales contract shall be communicated to the holders of preemption rights by way of public notice through the notary. Then the agricultural administration body shall check and examine the sales contract and the statement of acceptance and shall adopt a decision within 15 days of receipt of the documents for the refusal of approval of the contract of sale. If one of the cases listed in the Act occurs, if the agricultural administration body decided not to refuse the approval of the sales contract, it shall contact the regional body of the Hungarian Association of Agriculture, Food and Rural Development, where the land affected by the contract is situated, so namely the local land commission, to make its opinion. So the local land commission shall consider the local situation, the public knowledge, and the criteria specified in the Act. Based on these criteria, the local land commission shall formulate its opinion whether to support the approval of sales contract of the holders of preemption rights listed in the protocol or the buyer. The agricultural administration body shall take into consideration the opinion of the local land commission in its decision, shall consider again the conditions of approval of refusal of the sales contract, and shall make its resolution, which shall be endorsed. In the case of disposition of property upon death, and it is the part of the second group, so the same restrictions shall be applied to the acquisition of ownership land as to other acquisitions of ownership falling within the scope of the Land Transaction Act. Ownership acquisition rights shall exist on the condition that the acquiring party undertakes in the contract for the transfer of ownership not to permit third party use of the land and to use the land himself, and in that context to fulfill the obligation of land use, and agrees not to use land for other purposes for a period of 5 years from the time of the acquisition. Furthermore, ownership acquisition right shall exist on condition that the acquiring party provides a statement enclosed with the contract for the transfer of ownership, of having no outstanding fee or debt owed in connection with land use, as established by final ruling relating to any previous land use. Moreover, that he had not been found to be involved during the period of 5 years before the acquisition in transaction aiming to circumvent restrictions and acquisitions. As regards the approval of acquisition land by way of testamentary disposition, the provision on preemption rights, holders of preemption rights, on statements of acceptance made by holders of preemption right, and the protocol and on the owner's right to choose, and on the related designations to be made by the agricultural administration body shall be ignored. Difference, even compared to the approval of the contract of sales, sale by the competent authority, is that in this proceedings, the opinion of the Lowland Commission need not to be requested. The agricultural administration body shall consider the eligibility of the heir and as to whether testamentary disposition is predisposed to breach or circumvent restrictions on land acquisition. The agricultural administration body shall communicate its decision to the notary public as well. If the agricultural administration body refuses to approve the acquisition of title by the heir and the land in question is transferred under state ownership and assigned to the National Land Fund, the heir shall be entitled to compensation. The amount of this compensation shall cover the value established by the appraisal of property minus the estate debt falling upon the state as the heir. So the person exercising ownership rights shall provide for having the appraisal prepared and for the payment of compensation within 60 days from the date of acquisition. This disposition shall not apply where the acquisition of ownership by the state materialized because the heir disclaimed the inheritance. And this provision entered into law on the basis of the decision number 4 of 2017 of the Constitutional Court. So the special rules on disposition of property upon death are fundamentally applicable to the inheritance of land, as the scope of the act extends to land. But one of general rules of the inheritance in the civil code applies specifically to agricultural holdings, namely in connection with the disclaimer of inheritance. On the basis of this, the heir shall be entitled to separately disclaim inheritance of farmland, its equipment, accessories, livestock, and tools and implements if he is not engaged in agricultural production by profession. With this, the Act gives the opportunity that a successor who is engaged in agricultural production by profession receives possibly the agricultural land and the adherent instruments. So this rule was considered favorable anyway because according to the main rule, the successor can reduce the estate only as a whole and only by the above mentioned inheritance assets can be disclaimed separately by the successor. In the current Hungarian nation, we can mention the providing of statements which is necessary for the acquisition ownership, the land acquisition limit, and the institution of the approval by the competent authority, the limitation of the freedom of testamentary disposition. So I consider that the specific rules of succession shall be adopted within the national legislation. On one hand, to eliminate the fragmentation of a state structure, while in the case of using the general succession rules for intestate succession, land may be fragmented easily. And the purpose of the introducing sui generis rule of land succession would be to hold the land as a unit. So on the other hand, it should be considered during the establishment of rules, which is not considered by the general rules of succession, that such a person shall be the heir who is competent, has special skills, and has practiced land cultivation. Thus, a proper farming would be done on the land. There are special rules for the acquisition of ownership of land by testamentary disposition. So in this case, a special nature of land was taken into account during the establishment of regulation, and it would be worth to approach the rules of intestate succession to this. In addition, the purpose of principles behind the land transaction is to promote the acquisition of those people who is able and willing to cultivate the land, but it is not provided in the case of using the general rules for intestate succession. The provision of testamentary disposition should be reconsidered in order not to give a chance to speculative land acquisition. And the specific rules should be established in one system in respect of both so the intestate succession and testamentary disposition. And so I would like a little bit to speak about so shortly about transfer of holdings inter vivos. But the Hungarian legislator is lagging behind in the development of rules on transfer of holding inter vivos. So legislation on agricultural holdings, which is a cardinal act under Article P of the Fundamental Law, has not yet been created. And at present, the Land Transaction Act, which is the only one of the legal acts prescribed for the area by Fundamental Law, so it does not contain a special rule in this regard. In the absence of special regulations, we can proceed from the provisions of our civil code. So the option regulated by the civil code is the transfer of fiduciary assets, but under the provision of the land of the Hungarian Transaction Act introduced on 1st July 2020, ownership of land may not be acquired by way of a fiduciary asset management contract. Thus, at present, we do not meet regulations on transfer holding inter vivos in Hungary. So now I would like to thank you for your attention.